The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Happy morning, students. I hope you would have seen the video of Halo Alkanes and Halo Arenes, where the focus area is being covered, that is the reaction and its mechanism. So today we are going to look at the topic alcohols, phenols and ethers. Now they all are being put into a single group where you have alcohols which are aliphatic, that is you have R which is an alkyl group, so it can be methyl, ethyl, propyl and so on, and you have phenols where the R is replaced by an aryl group, that is phenyl group, and then you have ether having ROR as its functional group. So today we will focus on all these three topics: preparation of alcohols, which focus on the main area preparation from alkenes. We know alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons having double bond in their compound. So acid catalyzed hydration. We know hydration is nothing but addition of water molecule, H2O. So acid catalyzed, that is you're going to use this hydration in the presence of an acid as a catalyst. So we have propene, which on hydration, this is nothing but H plus and OH minus, where the negative part will be attached to the carbon bearing less hydrogen atoms. So you get here 2-propanol or propen-2-ol. This is according to Markovnikov rule, because Markovnikov rule, we know when an unsymmetrical alkene is added to a reagent, the negative part of the addendum will be moving to the carbon which has got less hydrogen atoms. The next heading, that is the preparation of alcohol, is from hydroboration and oxidation. Hydroboration, hydrogen and boron is being added together. After that you are going to oxidize the compound, where I'm going to take propene. This is diborane, B2H6. BH3 twice is nothing but B2H6. But this process takes place opposite to Markovnikov rule, not with respect to Markovnikov rule, where the negative part will go to the carbon which is having more hydrogen atoms. So you get CH3, this H getting added to this carbon atom, the BH2 negative part goes to CH2. So now what happens here? Again, when a propene molecule is added, BH2 becomes BH and the propene molecule, the 3-carbon chain increases to 6-carbon. So you write CH3, CH2, CH2, BH. Again, when a propene molecule gets added, it becomes thrice the propene molecule with boron. That is, the number of hydrogen atom becomes less. It was BH3, it becomes BH2, it becomes BH, then it turns to B. But what is happening to propene? It becomes 1, here it becomes 2, and then here it becomes 3. Now this structure where it is CH3, CH2, CH2, thrice B, that is a boron, will now be undergoing oxidation in the presence of hydrogen peroxide. And also alkali can be added. Now this undergoes oxidation, so you get an alcohol, you get a primary alcohol, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH plus BOH thrice. So this process we call it as hydroboration and oxidation. The next preparation of alcohol is from carbonyl compounds. What happens in carbonyl compounds? First one is reduction. That is the CO, carbonyl compound is nothing but CO. The CO becomes CH2. You're going to remove oxygen and you're going to add hydrogen. That is called as reduction. Now, this reduction of the carbonyl compounds takes place by using reducing agents like lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride. These are very strong reducing agents. So, if I'm going to use an aldehyde, aldehyde is CHO. If aldehyde is used and in reduction, I get a primary alcohol. And if ketone is used for reduction, I get a secondary alcohol. So, using the reduction process of carbonyl compound, any aldehyde on reduction will yield primary alcohol. Any ketone on reduction will give us secondary alcohol. Now, next is reduction from carboxylic acid and ester. Now, if you see carboxylic acid, using lithium aluminium hydride on a strong reduction will directly give a primary alcohol. This COO double bond, that is this oxygen, will be removed and you're going to add hydrogen here. So it becomes CH2OH. This, because we know carbonyl compound has with CO, CO becomes CH2. So here RCOOH, this CO becomes CH2 and you, again you have a OH. But this acid can also be converted to an ester, which on reduction using a catalyst like palladium or platinum will be giving an alcohol, mixture of alcohols. Now, how does it take place? Say I take an acid here, RCOOH, this is my alcohol, R-OH. Both alkyl group can be different or can be same also. So, acid plus alcohol will give an ester. Ester on reduction, that is catalytic hydrogenation. This is called as catalytic hydrogenation. Hydrogenation means I am going to add hydrogen in the presence of catalyst. So I am going to get RCH2OH and R-OH. There are two hydrogens here. H2, two hydrogen. One hydrogen goes here, one hydrogen goes here. So catalytic hydrogenation becomes RCH2OH and R-OH. So this is the basic preparation of alcohols from alkenes and carbonyl compounds. The next preparation is using Grignard reagent, which is a very important preparation as of this lesson is concerned. So we'll be seeing how alcohols can be prepared using Grignard reagent. Now let us see how alcohols can be prepared from Grignard reagent. If you see this reaction, children, I have taken formaldehyde, other aldehydes, and also I have taken a ketone. Now what happens here, RMGX is a Grignard reagent. R stands for an alkyl group, Mg magnesium, and X stands for a halogen. Now this Grignard reagent, when it gets added to a formaldehyde, how this happens? The alkyl group comes and attacks the carbon. The double bond, one of the bond gets shifted to oxygen. So oxygen will carry a negative charge and the magnesium comes in, joins this oxygen. So I get carbon, two hydrogens, an alkyl group and OMGX. Which on hydrolysis, this bond breaks. I have H plus and OH minus. H plus comes and joins with oxygen. OH joins this magnesium halide. So I get my primary alcohol and MgOHX. So whenever I want to prepare a primary alcohol, I should be using formaldehyde. So formaldehyde, when it is treated with Grignard reagent, it always yields a primary alcohol. Now if I want to prepare a secondary alcohol, what am I supposed to take? I will be taking aldehydes other than formaldehyde. Say I can take ethanol, I can take butanol, propanol, any aldehyde. Again, when treated with RMGX, the same thing happens. R comes and attacks the carbon, double bond gets shifted to oxygen, magnesium attacks the oxygen. So I get R2CHOMGX, which on hydrolysis will give R2CHOH, which is my secondary alcohol. But if I take a ketone, If a ketone is taken as a reactant, it will definitely yield a tertiary alcohol, because ketone already has two alkyl group, and when again an alkyl magnesium halide, that is when a Grignard reagent added, three alkyl groups joins this carbon, so it becomes a tertiary alcohol. So formaldehyde gives primary, other aldehyde gives secondary, and ketone gives a tertiary alcohol. Now these are the preparations of alcohols. Now let us see the preparations of phenol. We have two important preparation. First one is from halobenzene, that is when chlorobenzene is treated with an alkali, that is when it is fused with an alkali like sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, you get O minus Na plus, which when treated with HCl, with a mineral acid, you get phenol. The OH comes and attacks, H comes and attack oxygen, sodium takes the chlorine and comes out as sodium chloride. So that is the first preparation of phenol. In the second preparation, we already know it is from benzene diazonium salts. So here aniline, which is a benzene diazonium chloride starter. So aniline, when it is treated with sodium nitrite and HCl, you get a benzene diazonium chloride, which on hydrolysis and slightly warming, you get your phenol. N2 separated and HCl also comes out, because here H2O is nothing but H plus OH minus. So when OH minus comes and attacks the benzene, H takes the Cl and comes out as HCl, nitrogen gas also evolves out. So these are the two preparations of phenol from halobenzene and diazonium salt. Now we will see some chemical reactions of alcohol. Yes children, the next important is the chemical properties, or I will say the chemical reactions of alcohols, where the first test is called as a Lucas test, which helps us to distinguish between the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. That is, this test will be useful for us to understand which alcohol is the given compound, whether it is primary or secondary or tertiary. Now this is a reaction where an alcohol is going to be treated with hydrogen halides. Now we have a reagent which is called as Lucas reagent, which is a mixture of concentrated HCl with anhydrous zinc chloride. Mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride, where if it is the given compound is a tertiary alcohol, it will give immediate turbidity. What is turbidity? Not a clear solution. If it is a secondary alcohol, the turbidity will be formed, but not as soon as the reaction is completed, but after 5 minutes. And if it is a primary alcohol, there will be no chance of turbidity formation. So this test actually helps us to differentiate between primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. Now how does the reaction takes place? An alcohol, when it is treated with hydrogen halide in the presence of zinc chloride, it gives an alkyl halide, that is haloalkane plus removal of water. So this is going to be a tertiary, it gives immediate turbidity. If this alcohol is secondary, turbidity comes after some time, and if it is a primary, there will be no presence of turbidity. So that is a first reaction, which is a Lucas test reaction. The second one is a simple reaction, which is dehydration. If you remember children, how alcohols are formed from alkenes, the first reaction which we discussed today, that is acid catalyzed hydration. So this is a reverse reaction of that, which is dehydration. In an alcohol, when it is dehydrated, that is I am going to remove a molecule of water, what happens? Hydrogen and OH from this adjacent carbons are removed, I get a double bond formed here. So simple, when alcohols are dehydrated, it results in the formation of alkenes. So that's how you can prepare alkenes from alcohols. So here, if it's a primary alcohol, it requires a very high temperature. For secondary and tertiary, even at milder condition, the dehydration can take place. So with this, the chemical properties of alcohols are over as of focus point area is concerned. The next one is a chemical reaction of phenol. In this, nitration and Riemer-Thiemer reaction plays a very important role. Nitration, you have two types. First one is under dilute conditions. That is, when I'm going to use dilute nitric acid, I get a set of two products. One is orthonitrophenol, then we have paranitrophenol. Where paranitro is actually a major product, but what happens here is, now these two are a mixture of ortho and para, but these can be separated because one is actually steam volatile. See, in this you can see there is a type of molecular bonding takes place. If I take my orthonitrophenol, there is an intramolecular hydrogen bonding. What do you mean by intramolecular? Intra means some bonding that is taking place within the molecule. That is, there is an interaction between two molecules within the same molecule, two atoms within the same molecule. So that's why we call this as intramolecular, and this becomes intermolecular. And this ortho product of this phenol is actually steam volatile because of this bonding. And the same phenol, when it is going to be treated with concentrated nitric acid, the product that we get is 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, which is also called as picric acid. This is a very important preparation of picric acid. How picric acid can be prepared from phenol, or what happens when phenol is heated with concentrated nitric acid. So with this, nitration of phenol is over. Then we have another important reaction, which is called as Riemer-Tiemann reaction. This is used for the preparation of salicylaldehyde. An aldehyde group is going to be introduced into a phenol group. Now how does the reaction happens? Phenol, when it is treated with chloroform and aqueous alkali, I get an intermediate. This is my intermediate. What is there here? I have phenol, where this H is replaced by alkali, that is sodium, and then I have CHCl2 introduced at the ortho position. Benzene, O minus Na plus, ortho position has CHCl2, which again on treatment with an aqueous alkali, this CHCl2 gets oxidized to CHO. And there, which on hydrolysis in presence of a mineral acid acidification, you get your phenol with CHO at the ortho position, which is called as salicylaldehyde. So these are the two important preparations of phenol. Now we'll be dealing with the last topic of this chapter, which are called as ethers. We'll see one important compound of alcohol, that is ethanol, which we have already learnt in our 10th standard. We'll just give a small brush up to that, and then we'll get into our ethers. Now, before getting into ethers, we have some important alcohol where ethanol is being given to us. Just like chloroform, which we learnt in haloalkane chapter. Preparation of ethanol, which we have learnt in our 10th standard, children, if you can recollect. Ethanol is prepared by the fermentation of sugar, molasses, where sugar is being fermented, where you get your glucose and fructose in presence of invertase as your enzyme. And these glucose or fructose in presence of zymase will be giving you an ethanol, that is an alcohol. Now, ethanol is unfit for drinking, so to make it drinking, it is being denatured. We know that that is called as a process denaturation of alcohol, and that we call it as a denatured spirit. The same alcohol, ethanol, can be prepared by the hydration of alkene, which was the first preparation we saw in the preparation of alcohols. Right? So with that, alcohol is being getting over. Now to get on into ethers, ethers has a molecular or a functional group of ROR, where it has been prepared by the two processes. The first process is also called as Williamson synthesis, which is important for our focus area. In Williamson synthesis, the most important thing which we should remember is we should always be taking a primary alkyl halide. So here we have a sodium salt of alkyl alcohol, that is, which is going to be treated with an alkyl halide, which will be giving us an ether with the removal of sodium bromide or sodium halide. Now what happens here? CH3CH2Br, when it is going to react with its sodium salt, NaBr will be removed. So you get CH3CH2OCH3. The things that we should remember is always take a primary alkyl halide. So when I take a primary alkyl halide, this sodium will combine with the bromine, and thus sodium bromide comes out. Now, what if I'm going to take a tertiary alkyl halide? So, in the place of a primary alkyl halide, if a tertiary alkyl halide is being taken and the sodium salt becomes a primary, so what happens? Here, instead of formation of an ether, you get an alkene with the removal of certain groups like methanol and sodium bromide. One of the hydrogen from here goes and attaches with CH3O, so you get CH3OH. Sodium combines with the bromine and forms sodium bromide. So since one hydrogen has been lost, there will be a formation of a double bond. So whenever I take a tertiary alkyl halide, I don't get ethers, instead an alkene will be formed. Similarly, you can also prepare aromatic ethers using phenol. Phenol, when it is fused with an alkali like sodium hydroxide, you get O minus Na plus on the benzene ring, which when treated with an alkyl halide, removal of sodium halide with the formation of an ether. So these are the preparations of ether. Now there are two important preparations of ethers, out of which one is of very much importance in focus area. And when you come to chemical reactions, two reactions are there: Friedel-Crafts alkylation and Friedel-Crafts acylation. In alkylation, we know we take alkyl halide in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, which is being used as a catalyst. So here this is anisole, benzene with OCH3, aryl OR, which is called as an aromatic ether. The name, common name, is given as anisole. So anisole, when it is treated with methyl chloride in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, you get 2-methoxytoluene. Because we know benzene with CH3 is called as toluene. Where you have an OCH3 methyl oxygen, you call it as methoxy. So this is called as 2-methoxytoluene, and this is 4-methoxytoluene. So you get your ortho and para product. The same anisole, when it is treated with acid chloride in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, you get 2-methoxyacetophenone. If you remove this OCH3, it becomes acetophenone. So this is called as 2-methoxyacetophenone and 4-methoxyacetophenone. So these two are the important reactions, chemical reactions of ethers, aromatic ethers, when it is treated with alkyl chloride and acid chloride, which we call it as Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. So always remember, when we are writing acylation and alkylation, definitely you should write the catalyst, which is anhydrous aluminium chloride. So with this, alcohol, phenols and ethers are getting over, children. I hope you are able to follow the reactions and its mechanism. If you do have doubts, please do not hesitate. Please ask me through phone or when you come to school. Okay, thank you so much. Definitely I'll be posting the next video of the following organic chemistry topic. Thank you.